Munich Reinsurance America's parent company in Germany established a goal for its entire organization to be carbon neutral by 2015. To meet this goal, Munich Reinsurance America embarked on a series of extensive upgrades to its home office in Plainsboro, New Jersey, including moving to full digital controls across the campus with a new building automation system and upgrading over 8,000 T8 deep cell parabolic fixtures with T5 volumetric fixtures. Paul Lupica, head of facilities and vice president with Munich Reinsurance America, discusses how they manage the human component of installing innovative systems.
A lot of what we do is, you know, technology-based, but at the end of the day, we are customer support people servicing the needs of our employee population. So, for example, when we put in the new digital-controlled BAS system, we had to get away from a lot of the favorite sons, if you will, where this person likes it this temperature and that person likes it that temperature. This person likes their lighting, X, and this person likes their lighting Y. Because the reality is you can have two people who are literally sitting within 10 feet of each other. I'm hot, I'm cold. So what we had to do is come up with some baseline standards that we were going to apply uniformly across the organization. So we came up with, and we know they're generous because we're owner-occupied, but we came up with baseline standards of temperature X to temperature Y. If the space is within those temperatures, we have to basically put our foot down and say, this is the temperature we offer across the board to the organization. However, if we are not supplying that temperature on normal temperature days, then it's our obligation to make sure that, in fact, we do provide you with temperatures in that zone that we've collectively agreed are the temperature standards for your organization. So we involve the people in the process to a degree to make sure that they were on board with it. Going back to the lighting, again, talking about the technology piece versus the soft and fuzzy, we didn't just pick out a light fixture and throw it in across 400,000 square feet. We mocked up areas. We went to some tough customers and we said, okay, we're going to change out the lighting in your entire area. We want you to try it out for a couple of months. Not 2 days, a couple of months. And we got their feedback. And they actually gave us some very good feedback that we incorporated into the final design. So we wanted to make sure it was an iterative process throughout. Not just, here's a solution, put it in and walk away. We wanted to make sure that the employee population, our customers, were involved in the process and gave us valuable feedback that translated into slight changes here and there in the ultimate end product. We tell people that there's a reason behind this. We tie it to the carbon neutrality. We tie it to reducing expenses, which is good for everybody in the organization. So we want to make sure that that's all linked together in a complete message, not just little pieces of information like we're changing your lighting. Why are you changing our lighting? To reduce the wattage per fixture, to reduce our expenses, to reduce our carbon footprint. There's a story behind it. It's not just a policy that we're trying to force on people.
Not only were the systems and strategies employed at Munich Reinsurance America innovative, Lupica admits he himself might not have considered them in the past. That has changed.
Never say no to anything right off the bat. Everything deserves some consideration because, quite frankly, some ideas that were brought to me, I might have, offhand said, no, we're not going to do that here. Stop, listen, and think about it because the world is evolving and so is facilities management. And you have to make sure you have a very open mind about some of these new innovative ideas that are coming out every day. Things are changing because if you look at what we're actually doing today and even thought about them 10 years ago, they never would have gotten any consideration. Now, some of those very same ideas are becoming mainstream. So who knows what idea I'm hearing now will be the mainstream idea 10 years from this point. So again, you have to keep a very open mind about those suggestions and also the variety of resources and sources from which they come.
To learn more about this project and the other 2012 FM Excellence winners, check out the August 2012 issue of Building Operating Management.